Welcome to Kotek. In this tutorial, we will walk you through the core functionalities of WinTAK, the Windows version of the Team Awareness Kit. If you have not performed the initial setup of WinTAK, including connecting to the Kotek server, click the banner in the top right or navigate to kotek.gov and search for the WinTAK Getting Started tutorial. Let's begin by opening the WinTAK app. If WinTAK has already been installed on your device, it is best practice to make sure your version is up to date. To do this, click the drop-down menu in the top left of WinTAK, then select About. At the top of this page, you will see the version of WinTAK your device is operating on. To check if you are running the latest version, navigate to kotek.gov and log in. Click on Support, Download, and scroll down to WinTAK Downloads. Here, you will see the most recent version of the WinTAK installer. If this version does not match your current version of WinTAK, click the icon, then click Save. Navigate through the installer and setup wizard as demonstrated within the first video, then open the WinTAK application. When you open the WinTAK app, you see a base map with a variety of icons that show your location and the locations of other first responders. If your Windows computer has access to location services through a GPS puck or other technology, your location will be shown as a blue pointer arrow, which points the direction that your device is moving. If you do not have GPS, you may manually set your location by clicking in the bottom right corner and then clicking the map. Other TAK app users are shown as multicolored dots, with the color of the dot controlled by the user's team color. Kotek uses a standard to indicate what type of first responder a dot color corresponds to. Refer to the Kotek guidance on this standard. Any dot, including your own, can be tapped on to receive more information on the item, or access the tools. Note that when tapping on a dot, the call sign for the dot appears on the map as well as the coordinates, elevation, GPS error, speed, and direction. This same information is available for yourself at the bottom right of the screen if you have GPS reception. A wheel of options also appears on a dot when tapped on. Starting at the 2 o'clock position, going clockwise is the breadcrumb tool, which when tapped causes the user to leave a trail of breadcrumbs behind them as they move about the map. Next is the chat option, which when clicked on allows you to send messages to other TAK app users. Note that this option is not available for other map markers. Next is the details page, where you can view additional data on the item, including, when applicable, the version of TAK used by the user, their battery life, and the time their location was last updated. You can also view the user's coordinates and their distance and bearing from you. Next is the trash can, which will delete the marker from your map and your map only. For markers that correspond with TAK app users or vehicles in motion, a deleted marker will reappear on your map when their location is next updated. Next is the polar coordinate entry tool, which is generally relevant for military operations. Then, the four arrows are the fine adjustment tool for the marker, if you need to manually adjust the placement of a marker. The two-ended arrow incorporates a measuring tool from the marker to a location you designate. Next, you can lock on this marker, meaning the map will stay centered on this item. Note the padlock turns blue in the upper left of the toolbar to designate that this feature is active. You will almost always use this to lock on yourself, while in motion, or on another user in motion. To unlock the map, tap again on the blue lock icon. Across the top of the WinTAK app is the toolbar, which contains tools used by the app. A standard set of tools is displayed when you launch WinTAK for the first time, though the placement of these tools can be customized by you later using the Toolbar Manager. We will now review some of the most commonly used WinTAK tools from left to right. Clicking on Overlays opens the Overlay Manager. Think of overlays as items placed on top of your base map, which is changeable in the Maps and Favorites tool. You can toggle all of these individual items on or off. We'll cover teams, image overlays, and file overlays. These same principles apply to other choices within the Overlay Manager menu. Most importantly, in this first menu, toggling the buttons basically performs a reset, meaning if you've deselected visibility of some of these items, you can quickly re-enable visibility with two clicks. For example, I've previously disabled visibility of search and rescue resources, in this case, the orange dots. Here, you can see they've been deselected within the team field. By toggling at this highest level, I quickly re-enable all dots I've deselected. The opposite is true. I can make all dots, markers, image overlays, and the remaining options invisible by toggling off. You may choose to toggle off certain marker colors in a complex incident in a small geographic area. Image overlays include individual maps which have been imported into WinTAK. This is possible by simply dragging and dropping a compatible file onto the map. Maps can be toggled on or off or deleted individually within the image overlays. Finally, file overlays contain GIS data like shapefiles or KMLs, which have previously been imported into WinTAK. Similar to image overlays, these files can be manipulated individually or in bulk through this tool. The GoTo tool allows you to enter coordinates in a variety of formats or enter a street address. Leaving the No Point option selected and clicking OK will pan the map to the location entered. You may also select one of the 5-point options to drop a point at the location. Within the Contacts tool, the three people, you can see who is connected and using TAC. This can be useful for rostering or status of in-route units. Tapping on the dot of a contact pans the map to center on that user's location. Additionally, you can message your TAC contacts. While at first, this doesn't seem that useful, in a mutual aid scenario, you can message directly to individuals you've never met before, nor may even know their name apart from their call sign. The range and bearing tools are accessed by tapping on the tab at the top of the app. The Bloodhound tool is used to indicate a direct line from a selected user or location to another user or marker. Most of the time, there will be a marker of interest and you want to know how far it is and the most direct route to arrival. The Bloodhound tool does not account for routing around terrain, roads, or trails. It is simply as the crow flies. Select the Bloodhound tool, select from what you'd like to Bloodhound, use the crosshairs to select a different starting point, and use the crosshairs to select a finishing point. Each end of the Bloodhound must be a marker. Tap the trash can icon next to the Bloodhound to delete it. Other commonly used range and bearing tools include Measure, which allows you to measure distances without snapping to a map marker. Clicking on a line and the Details option shows a variety of distances and bearings for the line, and clicking the trash can option allows you to delete the line. The Dynamic Measure option allows you to quickly change the start and end points of the line. This concludes the introduction tutorial for WinTAK, powered by the Colorado Department of Public Safety and the Center of Excellence for Advanced Technology Aerial Firefighting. To learn more, visit us at cotac.gov.